Devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Ocala's Information Station, 1370 WOCA. Ocala!
Thank you, Mandy. It's 16 minutes after 7 o'clock. It is February 27th, 2014. It's a wet and chilly Thursday morning here in Ocala. We're broadcasting, of course, from the Paddock Law. And good morning, Robin. How you doing over there?
Good morning, Larry. It's grand over here.
Was it raining on your way in?
Grand. Yes, it was.
Was it?
It was raining, but no fog today. Yesterday was a lot of fog.
And right now, in case you're wondering, the temperature here at the Paddock Mall is 46 degrees.
Gosh.
46 degrees, Robin.
Chilly.
All right, let's see. We've got a good show planned for today, and looking forward to doing the whole thing with everybody. The first part, of course, the first feature is 7:30. It's Bring Back the Bible. Pastor Walter B. Smith prepares that and writes that and produces that and sends it to us, and we put it on the air.
Yeah,
he's the pastor of Heritage Baptist Church. Always look forward to hearing what he has to say.
Yeah.
7:35 today. This Sunday is the Academy Awards, Robin.
Yep.
The Oscars.
Yep.
The best of the best, according to those who vote on the Academy Awards. Right?
Yeah.
And did you ever know anybody who was nominated for any category at all, since you did work with the movie people a little bit?
Let's see. Not directly.
Not directly.
No,
okay.
Not directly.
Well, if you are nominated... You get a questionnaire from the Oscars.
Oh,
and the
cool.
questionnaire asks you certain things. And so I want to read to you what some of the nominees from this year's Oscars responded. My favorite question is, how did you find out that you won?
Oh, wow.
And then they tell their stories. Some of them are handwritten. Some of them, they went through the trouble of putting it into their computers and typing it up. And it's fun. I thought you'd find that fun.
It is fun. I do know Joe Camp, though. When he and I were emailing last year, he was walking the red carpet because his son was nominated for some movie because he was the director. And then I had sent Joe an email, and then he sent it back from my iPhone going, I'm on the red carpet. He's the creator of Benji.
Thank you. Yeah. And I knew who he was. I wanted you to say.
Soul of the Horse and all that. Yeah, so right from the red carpet, he sent me an email text kind of thing. So
you are so
cool.
In touch with these people, Robin. you're getting email. You're getting text messages from the red carpet at the Oscars.
Yeah, he was so excited.
I'm sitting at home trying to figure if I got more peanut butter in the back of the refrigerator somewhere. You're kidding me.
No, I'm not.
Wow.
No, that's so cool.
Wow.
Joe is such a great guy.
He is such a great guy, right?
Yeah.
Okay. He's still around, right?
Oh, he is. He is.
All right,
yeah.
I thought you said he was.
He's got a new book series out, Soul of the Horse, and all that good stuff. So.
All right. So anyway, so we'll talk about. His son?
His son
was nominated. So his son got that nomination questionnaire, that nominee questionnaire.
Probably, yeah.
Fun. Mm-hmm. One day maybe I'll know somebody who gets one.
So that's as close as we
can. Well, that's pretty cool. I was kind of shot in the dark that you would even know that, anybody. Okay.
Yeah.
8:35 today, News Bites. We'll take the news from around the world, around the nation, around the state, and around town, and we will shorten it so that you can hear a bunch of news in a short period of time and get on with your day. 9 o'clock today, Hank Whittier will be in the studio bringing you veterans news, as he does every Thursday. Always look forward to those guys coming in.
Yep.
Dr. Richard Solomon is coming into the studio at 10:05. He's coming in with Dr. Joyce Urban. They are coming in to talk to us about the Play Project. This is something we heard about when we had a young lady in here. Oh, please remember. Thank you. Anyway, so the Play and Language for Autistic Youngsters is what this is about.
Yep, they're having an intensive workshop this weekend. Dr. Joyce Urban and her husband, Dr. Urban, they're the ones that provide all the beautiful things at Christmas time at the Appleton Museum.
Okay, and Delsa's name is on here somewhere, so I don't forget her name?
Yep.
Okay, well, I'll see it.
To the left.
Oh, there it is, Delsa,
tiny
darling.
Letters.
Thank you, Robin.
You're welcome.
For those who don't know, Robin keeps me in line here. 10:35 this morning, Wesley J. Smith, named by the National Journal as one of America's leading experts in the area of bioethics.
Yep, he's a bioethician. That's a new word. I got to find out what that means.
Really? He's a senior fellow at the Discovery Institute Center on Human Exceptionalism. He's written a book called The War on Humans, Defending Human Dignity Before It's Too Late. Oh, interesting.
Yeah, he's saying that a lot of people are revering the lives and the care of animals more than they are of humans.
That is true.
And we're in a downward spiral here.
That is true. I wonder how he feels about the thing Galen and I were talking about one morning. Galen had sort of kind of a debate on the topic. Not that I disagreed with Galen, but I did agree with what he was saying. He was making good points, but it was about the, what was it called, the bioprinting.
Yes.
Actually being able to print organs, and while that sounds magnificent, maybe there's some ethical.
Yep.
Close words mean two different things. Ethical reasons why we shouldn't do those things. So anyway, so it'll be interesting to hear what he has to say.
I'm sorry. It's a typo.
Oh, it should be a doctor. Thank you.
It should be Dr. a DR. I'll change that.
Mark Levy is an ophthalmologist at the Sarasota Retina Institute.
I
and
need
he wants
new
to
glasses.
Talk to us about.
I do.
A new treatment option for patients with end stage macular degeneration.
Yep.
That could be good news, huh?
It could be. Very good news.
Mary Ann Farley is coming on later on, 11:20. She was diagnosed with essential thrombocythemia.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do when you're in the doctor's office and he comes in with that clipboard? He says, Mary, is what we figured out. You got some essential thrombocythemia. What? What do I have?
That's right. That's right. It's a rare So we should.
Remember the joke about the guy?
What?
The guy went to see this doctor, and he was having some pain, and so the nurse had given the doctor some European nuts.
Oh.
Outside the door. and he was eating some, so he was looking at his clipboard and he misunderstood the patient when the patient said, "Doc, what is it?" He said, "Oh, European nuts." He goes, "Oh, no wonder it hurts so much."
I've never heard that joke before.
I messed it up.
That's a funny joke.
I messed it up.
Yeah, I get the gist.
All right, so anyway, she's coming on to speak to us about her disorder, her diagnosis. The challenges faced by patients with this rare disorder, as well as other rare disorders. Okay.
Right, rare disease disorders.
I will not tell her that joke. It sounds like it's going to be a serious topic. I'll behave. Fun with Joe. I got a good one today. I kind of was able to dovetail it with the Oscar bit we're doing.
Mm-hmm.
I will tell you and Joe the year. I will tell you and Joe the title of the movie.
Okay.
Your job is to tell me the actor who won the Oscar for that movie that year.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So I'll tell you the year.
Okay.
The name of the movie. All you have to do is tell me the actor who won the Oscar, okay?
Okay. I got it.
Pretty good, huh? That should be a simple one. Yesterday was a little bit complex, right?
It was fun yesterday.
Our segment with Galen. We did this once before, but there are some new ones out there, and we haven't done it in a long time. The topic, and it was years ago, I think we did this, weird vending machines, things you can buy from vending machines.
Oh, wow.
Remember we had this once before?
Yes.
Well, it doesn't stop. So I've got 10, actually 9, 9 new weird vending machines.
Wow.
9 new weird vending machines. There was a 10th one, but it was dispensing drug paraphernalia. And I said, I'm not going to put that one in there.
There you go. I mean, they're having trouble, you know, purchasing the drugs. You know, do they have money to put money in a vending machine for the paraphernalia? I don't think so.
I don't know. It was in Toronto, so maybe I think it's illegal in Ocala, but it would be legal in Toronto. All right, so there you go. That's our morning lineup. Let me real quickly do some things here. Did you hear that? What's his name died? Hold on, I'll tell you. Jim Lang. The dating game?
No, I didn't hear that.
The host of the dating game, Jim Lang.
Oh, my gosh.
He was 81 years old. He died at his home in Mill Valley, California. Interesting thing.
Wow.
Farrah Fawcett appeared on the dating game. Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
Famous.
I didn't know that. Was she like the one that picked the bachelor, or was she one of the bachelorettes?
She was one of the bachelorettes.
Oh.
She was described or introduced as an accomplished artist and sculptress.
Oh, wow.
On the dating game show. But anyway, she's already passed on too, right?
Oh, yeah. A lot of years.
Anyway, so Jim Lang, host of the dating game, no longer with us.
I can picture his face.
And if I understand the news, I think pretty soon we will not be telling Galen that the Life South is next in Donnell and is next to Sweet Bay. I think we'll be saying Winn-Dixie.
Oh.
But isn't there a Winn-Dixie over there already?
Yes.
So I think the Sweet Bays in our community are becoming Winn-Dixies, right? You heard that?
Yeah, we heard like a few months ago that Winn-Dixie was buying up the Sweet Bays.
Yeah, but it was in the news this morning.
So,
I wonder what they do when there's two of them. Isn't there a Winn-Dixie in Bellevue?
Yeah.
And there's a Sweet Bay.
Yes, so they'll have to close one probably.
Don't ask you what they're going to do.
Because they're only like 3 blocks away.
I don't know what they're going to do, Robin. Don't know.
Well, that's just like they're building that new Publix here. And once it's done by the high school, they're going to close the one here and next to the Paddock Mall. That's what they said.
Yeah, and that's going to become a bowling alley.
Probably, yeah.
I don't know. I just made that up.
It's huge.
Also, the sheriff's department arrested the kids that were shooting BB guns at cars, et cetera. Turns out they're not kids. They're all adults. They're young adults, but they're still adults.
Oh, how stupid are they?
A 20-year-old, an 18-year-old, another 18-year-old, and a 21-year-old.
That's stupid.
Over 100 cases. 33 cases in Marion County.
Oh, gee.
Over 100 in other cities and counties. Detectives Osborne and Spillman received a tip from Crime Stoppers, it says here, about the individuals who were shooting BBs at cars and homes.
Gosh.
And we got 4 suspects, the 20-year-old, 18, 21, and 18.
Good.
The 4 individuals who all live in Weirsdale.
Uh-huh.
Or in the Weirsdale area, have confessed to the crimes and stated they were bored and looking for something to do.
There you go.
They are 20. The youngest is 18. Hello?
No, they just like to be destructive. Put him in jail for a few years.
No, sign him up for the Army, Robin.
Oh, there you go.
They want to shoot guns?
Oh, sure. There you go. Just mandate it.
It'll help them. It'll be a favor to them.
That's right. That's right. Mandate. Put them in the Army. Mandate it.
Let's see. Some other things in the news. They've discovered more planets. 715 more planets have been discovered. Just all at once?
I know. I mean, was it just like a huge, you know, flux of a carnation shape? And it's like, woo, there are more planets.
NASA announced that it had discovered 715 more planets in the Milky Way galaxy.
Oh, gee.
Not to be confused with the Snickers galaxy.
No.
Well,
they downgraded Pluto.
I know. Poor Pluto. In our own neighborhood.
Exactly.
We demote a planet.
That's right.
And now we find 715 more.
Yeah,
and I don't know how they know this, but of the 715, mm-hmm. 4 could support life. Now, how do they know that?
Beats me.
I have a theory about life, by the way.
What?
How do we know that life isn't simply wavelength. We've heard this from so many different authors and scientists and theorists.
Yeah.
People with theories, right?
Right.
How do we know that it's not just a wavelength and that life here is what we experience because we're in tune with the wavelengths of life that is here?
Ooh.
I mean, maybe there's life going on every planet.
That's profound.
But we're not in tune with those wavelengths.
Mm-hmm.
I was looking at this list of spectrums from different stars, and there are some blank spots in the spectrums, and then it's explained why there's a blank spot, which would be printed as black ink.
Right.
It's because the human eye can't perceive the wavelength of whatever color is there.
Oh gosh.
So there are colors out there that you and I can't perceive, nor do we have the equipment to perceive it, I guess, but we can perceive that there is something there.
Right.
So we can perceive with our equipment something that is invisible.
Yes, we can. Invisible. Isn't that fascinating?
Invisible.
Yeah.
Right. So if there's something invisible on, let's say, Mars and all life form, I don't know, does this sound stupid or science fiction?
No, it doesn't. It's very fascinating.
All right.
So what? Continue.
Well, that's it. That's my whole theory is that maybe there's life on every planet.
That's a good theory.
Maybe
it doesn't have to be like humans. It could be microorganisms
right.
or something.
So maybe the four planets have similar wavelengths to us.
Yeah.
I don't know. Does that sound too far-fetched?
No, it doesn't. No, we talked to the guy with the black hole yesterday.
I know. You got my mind spinning. I know.
Yeah, this is fascinating.
All right, let's go to Pastor Walter B. Smith. He'll bring us back to Earth.
Yep.
And we'll be right back in just a bit.
Well, a good day to you, and welcome again to Bring Back the Bible. I'm Pastor Smith. This week we have been talking about the topic of self-defense in light of what the Bible says, the right to keep and bear arms. What does the Bible say about all of that? I ended the broadcast yesterday by saying to permit a murder when one could have prevented is morally wrong, and to allow a rape when one could have been hindered is an evil, and to watch an act of cruelty to a child without trying to intervene is certainly morally inexcusable. What I was saying is not resisting evil is an evil of omission. And an evil of omission can be just as evil, folks, as an act of commission. Any man who refuses to protect his wife and his children against a violent intruder fails them morally. Now, Scripture does not promote vengeance nor vigilantism, but it does allow believers to engage in self-defense, to resist evil, and to defend the defenseless. And I believe that we have the responsibility to defend ourselves, our family, and our home. Weapons are not the problem. Nowhere does the Bible forbid Christians from bearing arms. But wisdom and caution are certainly of the utmost importance if one does choose to bear a lethal weapon. Anybody who owns and carries a firearm should, number one, be properly trained. And number two, they should know and carefully follow all safety rules and laws pertaining to responsibility. But ultimately, the decision to bear arms is a personal choice determined by your own convictions. As a believer, the use of deadly force would be applied only as a last resort.
Hi, Robin. You look tired.
I am. I've been running all over town.
Why? Why not drive?
I need to get the stupid document notarized.
Well, that's easy. You need personal service.
Duh. That's what I've been looking for.
You need to go see Mark at the Personal Service Center. He can notarize that for you, make copies, fax it wherever, or send it out in the mail. Heck, he can even scan it and email it for you.
Really? Where is he at?
2375 Northeast 25th Avenue, on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street. You can call him at 789-6683.
Personal Service Center. Thanks, Larry.
ABC News Now. I'm Karen Chase. Gay rights advocates are applauding Arizona Governor Jan Brewer for vetoing a measure that would have allowed businesses to deny service to gay people. Hillary Clinton says Brewer recognized the need for inclusive leadership. A federal judge has declared Texas's same-sex marriage ban unconstitutional. The state attorney general's office is working on an appeal. How cold is it? So cold in the Midwest, a man walked 300 yards out onto Lake Michigan, frozen over for the first time in years. He was arrested when he came ashore in Chicago. Too little, too late? Federal safety officials are launching a probe into the GM recall to see if the company waited too long to call back hundreds of thousands of vehicles with possible ignition switch problems linked to over a dozen deaths. The mystery may have been solved. Investigators suspect the rare gold coins found by a California couple buried in their backyard may have been the same ones stolen years ago by an employee at the San Francisco Mint. NASA scientists have found more than 700 new planets outside our solar system, four inhabitable zones, places where life could exist. This is ABC News.
At Advance Auto Parts, saving big on the right oil is your advance advantage. Right now, you can get 5 quarts of Pennzoil conventional motor oil and a Purolator classic oil filter for just $22.99. Or, if your car's over 75,000 miles, you can step it up to Pennzoil high mileage oil for just $2 more. So step in to Advance Auto Parts and save on whichever oil you need. Either way, just get to stepping.
Advance Auto Parts.
See store for details.
You need a website. Why not do it yourself? You know your business. With Wix.com, you can create a professional website all by yourself. It's easy and free. With Wix.com, you don't need to be a programmer. Just use the intuitive drag-and-drop website builder. There's no limit to how creative you can be. It's your website, your style. Show the world what you can do. Create your own stunning website today. Go to Wix.com. It's easy and free.
This weather brought to you by George Mangan Insurance, putting their customers first since 1894. Call 352-732-3191. Your Ocala Auto Owners agent.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. Where in Florida? Mostly cloudy and cool today with some showers, the high 60 to 64. A lingering shower along the coast this evening, otherwise clearing and turning colder overnight with lows ranging from 35 inland to 48 on the beaches. Tomorrow, mostly sunny, high 68 to 72. Saturday, mostly sunny, high 74 to 78. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Beautiful Moments Party Rentals presents Showcase Under the Stars, a bridal affair to remember. This event has it all. Caterers, photographers, florists, DJs, venues, and more. All gathered in one place and all there to help you plan your special day. Brides, bring your bridesmaids and friends alike. This is the event you don't want to miss. There will be food, fun, trivia games, and prizes with different wedding-themed areas to explore. Tickets are only $10, and Beautiful Moments Party Rentals is donating 100% to the United Way of Marion County. Advance tickets can be purchased at Beautiful Moments Party Rentals, 3400 Southwest 60th Avenue in Ocala. Showcase Under the Stars takes place on March 13th from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m., so make plans to be there. Again, that's March 13th at Beautiful Moments Party Rentals from 5 to 9 p.m. If you have any questions, just give them a call, 307-8180, that's 307-8180, and make your plans to attend the Showcase Under the Stars.
Showcase Under the Stars.
All right, thank you, Kelly. 23 minutes before 8 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in this Thursday morning. Don't forget, Saturday, WOCA will be broadcasting from downtown. The Strawberry Festival is happening. It's the first annual Strawberry Festival to help benefit Habitat for Humanity. Habitat for Humanity is one of those organizations that Rob and I love. We have fallen in love with the organization. Robin and my sister participated in a all-women's build years ago.
Yep.
And I brought the sandwiches and took the pictures.
Yes, you did.
For
they
you
were
too.
Great.
For just the two of you, not for all the ladies.
And then your son and daughter-in-law participated in a build.
Yes, and
Habitat.
Okay. I mostly want to talk about the Strawberry Festival.
Okay.
The Strawberry and Craft Festival is this Saturday. It's the first annual, and Brad Nimmo, who's been with Habitat for as long as we've... In fact, he's the man who educated us about Habitat.
Oh, yeah.
He came in not too long ago with the young lady... Mm-hmm. I forget her name. I apologize. But anyway, they were telling us that he was telling us that he had done it once before in another community. And it sounds like it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to it. You and I have already purchased 2 flats of strawberries. We're going to have more strawberries than we know what to do with. But the thing is this, when you buy a flat of strawberries, you're actually contributing to Habitat for Humanity, which is a very, very super good cause. And for those of you who think they're giving away houses, you're wrong.
Yeah.
This is an opportunity for people who've had a hard time. It's a ministry, put it bottom line. And they will sell a house to the people who qualify.
Mm-hmm.
You have to have good credit. You have to worry. If you show up, you have bad credit, they will try to work with you so that give it a year.
Mm-hmm.
or so, you might be able to improve your credit and then get a house. The big difference between a normal mortgage and the money you get from Habitat is that there's no interest.
Yeah.
So you pay back exactly what it cost. You
know, yeah, that's you the wonderful part.
So it's a wonderful thing. And if you want to buy some strawberries, which is what I'm trying to get at here, you can do it in advance online at HabitatStrawberryFamilyFest.com.
Mm-hmm.
And then you click on the food thing, and it'll show your thing. And then what you do is you pay for your strawberries, you pick how many you want, and then they will email you the coupon or coupons that you've purchased.
Yes.
And then you just turn them in. Mm-hmm. Now, you don't have to actually even print them up. They said you can just show them on your phone. Show them your coupon on your iPhone.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah, I don't know how that works. I printed
that's
it up.
Cool.
I'm old-fashioned.
Me too.
But anyway, HabitatStrawberryFamilyFest.com. In addition to WOCA broadcasting live from the event, Joe Martone is setting up his tent 6 o'clock in the morning or something like that.
We'll be there.
Tom Schmitz is also broadcasting, from what I understand, the Saturday show that he does, so that ought to be fun.
Mm-hmm.
Chuck Wicks is going to be performing. Chuck is a Nashville recording artist. He's got a beautiful song called Stealing Cinderella.
Yeah.
To be honest with you, I had never heard of it before. I looked it up, listened to it, said, wow, that's a really good song.
It is very.
Make you tear up a little bit.
Yeah.
Victoria Sexton is also going to be performing. She's a beautiful young lady from our own community with a beautiful singing voice. So
yeah.
Very good to have her there. And other local bands too. I don't have all the names. There will be strawberries. There will be strawberry shortcakes. There will be chocolate-dipped strawberries.
Mm-hmm.
There will be vendors from near and far with something for everyone.
Yeah.
There will be the music I just talked to you about. There will be a pancake breakfast at 7 a.m. if you want to do that.
There you go.
There will be a car show. I don't know where they're going to do that, but someplace downtown they're going to have a bunch of cars.
Yeah.
There will be a pet parade at noon.
That's pretty
there
cool.
There will be a NASA simulator.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's one of those spinning things.
Yeah.
There will be face painting for the children or the adults if you want to get your face painted. There will be some inflatable fun things for the children. 9 of them, as a matter of fact. 9 inflatable fun things.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever, you know, those things you bounce around in.
Right, exactly.
There will be a karate demonstration.
Mm-hmm.
It just goes on and on. Other local performers, it says here. And so there you go. The farmers market also has extended hours from 8 a.m. till 5 p.m. on Saturday.
Yep.
So the farmers market and the strawberry festival all happening at the same time at the same place, downtown Ocala, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. We'll be there.
Yep, we will.
I'm going to give you an exception to that in just a little bit. Free admission, by the way. You don't have to pay anything.
Mm-hmm.
Have a good time. Show up. It's a nice way to kind of usher in the spring on the first day of March, this coming Saturday.
And the Habitat for Humanity folks will be there if you have any questions, if you feel you would like to have a home.
That's right. Or maybe get some information for somebody you know. And the only other thing I want to add to that is that you and I are going to step away from that for a little bit because we're coming back here to the Paddock Mall. We're participating in something here where we're reading. There are a number of people reading stories to children. What is their event called, do you know?
I don't know what that's called.
So we are
from 12 to
we
2.
Are two of several people who will be reading stories to children.
Mm-hmm.
The story we are reading is called The Gift of the Barking Frog.
Yep.
It is a story we wrote as part of the old Robin and the Giant radio show that we did 1997.
Yes.
Is that right? And it was a show that we did on digital cable radio, which became Sirius.
Yep.
And what do you call it? EX? What is it? MX?
XM.
XM.
Yeah.
And so we'll be doing that. And we will have the book that we made, which is a very big book. It's 576 pages, I think.
Yeah.
56 short stories that Robin and I wrote way back when. We used to write these short stories for the radio show that we did for children.
Yep.
About 8 years after the radio show was no longer on the air, we had all these stories and we decided to publish them.
Yes.
Well, actually, we had more than 56. These are the 56 that we liked the best.
Yeah.
We had way more than 56.
Oh, way more.
But anyway, so we published 56 of them, and they've always been available online. We just never really talk about them.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, we ordered one of those books, and we'll be giving it away. It's a nice... It should arrive today, right?
Yep.
Supposed to arrive
right
today.
Here.
So we'll be giving that away on Saturday to one child, one parent, I guess, is what we'll do.
Yeah.
Deal?
Deal.
All right. Now, something fun. The Oscar, for the Academy Awards are on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
And if you ever are nominated for an Oscar, you're going to get a questionnaire sent to you.
Okay.
And so I have some of the questionnaires from some of the nominees for this Sunday, for the 86th Oscars. And some of these names you will not know. For example, this one, Niv Adiri.
Don't know that name.
Is nominated for sound mixing.
Oh, wow.
For the movie Gravity.
Oh, okay.
How good of an ear do you have to tell that somebody is a better sound mixer than somebody else?
You've got to have a great ear.
Holy mackerel. Yeah. You get an award just for being able to nominate somebody.
Yeah, you have to have a great
ear. Anyway, Niv Adiri is nominated for sound mixing for the movie Gravity. Mm-hmm. The first question on the questionnaire is, how did you find out you had been nominated? Mm-hmm. His response, I got a text message from my wife. In parentheses, I was mixing at the time.
Oh.
The text was, you are nominated for an Oscar, exclamation mark, with an X. What's an X, a kiss, a hug?
Yeah, I think so.
So there you go.
I think it's a kiss. I think circles are hugs.
So there's one.
O's are hugs.
So I want to share that one with you?
Yeah.
Okay, do another one. The next one is a handwritten reply from K.K. Barrett. K.K. Barrett was nominated for production design for the movie Her.
Oh, okay.
Her is a movie, from what I understand, about a guy who falls in love with the computer, right?
Yeah, I think so. I think that's what that was.
This is the question. How did you find out you had been nominated? Here's the answer. I was woken up by Pete Franciosa, my agent, and told I was nominated. Then I told my wife, Trudy, who wanted to know what terrible news could somehow have that they had to call that early in the morning. I said it wasn't terrible news, it was great news. It didn't sink in until Spike called moments later and told me, boy, this is handwritten, it's hard to read the handwritten.
Yeah.
Told me, Karen and the soundtrack were nominated along with him for screenplay and the film for Best Picture. I guess Spike Jonze is who he's referring to.
I guess so, yeah. That's pretty cool.
It was completely unexpected, and it was with my really good friends. We are all self-taught filmmakers, and I never imagined being recognized by my peers.
No, oh,
big grin all morning.
Huge, huge grin, yeah.
There you go. So that was the reason I had a hard time, because it's handwritten.
And now that Trudy got over the shock and knows it's something good, she's out on Rodeo Drive getting a dress. She's spending his money.
Well, I don't know that you necessarily have more money coming in with these things.
No, but she's got to have a dress.
All right, so Christopher Burford, again, this is handwritten. I might not be able to really be pronouncing it right. Received a nominee for Achievement in Sound Mixing for Gravity.
Okay, so
boy, the sound mixing in Gravity must be really good.
Yeah.
So how did you find out you had been nominated is the question. Well, I was driving with my son to the nursery. My wife was watching the broadcast live. As soon as it ended, we pulled over to check the website. It was totally surreal, and my kids had to had to know what all the commotion was about. Okay, it's handwritten.
That is cool.
Handwritten, why I'm having a hard time
with
that.
Give me chills when you share it with your children.
Sorry that none of these are famous names, but it's fun.
No, but they're in fame. I mean, they're the guys that put the famous movies together, okay?
All right, the next one is David Brownlow is nominated for Best
Her.
Best sound mixing. It doesn't say what movie, though. Anyway, he goes, the question is, how did you find out you had been nominated? He says, my wife came in from the back house in her nightgown, holding her laptop, and she said, you've been nominated. From the back house.
The back of the house, maybe.
It doesn't say of the. It says the back house.
She should have been naked. That would have been a most opportune moment. Just, you know, she should have been naked, just had the laptop in front, Robin. And discarded it.
See, if I said that, everybody would be mad at me. What's the matter with you? All right. Now, here's one for... this one's typed out. I can read it. Didier Brunner was nominated for the animated feature film Ernest and Celestine.
Okay, have not heard of that.
How did you find out you had been nominated, it asks. I must admit, is the answer. I was waiting for the nominee list. When I got the news, I was impressed and proud and, of course, happy. Happy and happy. When I initiated this delicate, hand-painted film, Ernest and Celestine, I couldn't imagine an animated feature film with such a low budget could find its way to the Oscar and could compete with mammoth productions such as Frozen, The Croods, or Despicable Me, and against the legendary Hayao Miyazaki. In comparison, Ernest and Celestine is a very small mouse. Mm-hmm. But who knows, maybe Celestine will one day join Mickey Mouse in the Hall of Fame of Animation. I believe in it. So this guy's obviously very much involved with this movie I never ever heard of.
Yeah, and he said hand-painted, so I guess it's not the three-dimensional stuff like, you know, Frozen and all that.
I don't know.
Regular cartoon. Seeing,
everybody always makes fun. I don't see movies. I need to go see some movies. I did see the Blue Jasmine movie, though.
Yes. Yes, that was really, really good.
All right, let's go to the Netflix phone. Good morning. You're on the air.
You honestly do not know what a back house is.
Thank you. No,
thank
what
you.
Is it?
No,
what
I
is
don't.
It?
It's an old-fashioned outside toilet.
Really?
Really?
This lady's married to a nominee, and she has to go outside to use the bathroom?
To the outhouse with her laptop?
Well, I mean, maybe they just live way out somewhere and don't have the facilities, or maybe they want to live rural.
I can't believe that you thought I did. I should know that. How would I know that?
Yeah, we don't have one.
Because we always called it a back house.
Did you have a back house?
I certainly did the first 13, 14 years of my life.
Really?
Well, you don't have one now, do you?
Heavens no.
Okay, heavens no.
Yeah.
Well, heavens no. So you would think that this is heavens no for these people, too.
They, yeah.
I don't know what... I'm assuming...
Unless they have a little shed outside that they call a back house, but isn't really the old-fashioned back house.
All right. I have no idea. Aren't these people living in Los Angeles?
Yeah, they are.
Wow. Okay.
Well,
Google Maps, we got to zoom in on them.
That doesn't sound real.
I have no idea. All right. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Anyway, you got your lesson for the day.
Thanks for explaining it to me, Lucy. Thank you.
We got to go do Google Maps.
You know, when I read it, I thought that, actually. But I thought, yeah. There's no way. There's no way somebody has a back house if they're getting a nomination for an Oscar.
That's right. Maybe they have, like, AM.
Somebody's not paying somebody.
Something like that, yeah.
I want you to make a movie. I'm not going to pay you anything. You're going to have to keep that back house out there.
And she's in a nightgown with her laptop. So, I mean, that's got to be a big back house, you know? The roof has to be
maybe
opened up, signal so she can play.
Maybe the Lysol just doesn't work well enough, so they want to separate.
Oh, there you go.
All right.
Yeah, hers is worse than his.
Let me do a few more. Chris Buck was nominated for the animated feature Frozen. Doesn't say what he does or did. He says he found out about being nominated. His alarm went off at 5:30. What do these people get calls at real early in the morning? Right? I got up and I heard my fish tank making horrible bubbling and gurgling noises. It needed gallons of water. My dog wanted to be fed as I got out of bed and started barking.
Of course.
I was juggling, filling up buckets of water and feeding my dog while I was listening to the nominations on TV. So what? How did your fish tank? Is there a hole in it?
Yeah, exactly.
How is it possible that your fish tank needed gallons of water unless there was a hole in it?
Yeah, and how long does it take to feed your dog? I mean, you know, ripping.
Here's
the floor,
another one for sound mixing. This is Chris Burden. I'll do this one and then we'll stop. This is the sound mixer for the movie Captain Phillips.
Okay.
I can mix sound.
Yes, you can. You're excellent at it.
I don't know that I'm excellent. Nobody ever told me I was.
Well,
how does this become a category even?
Yeah.
Anyway, I watched.
Well,
how did
it.
You find out you had been nominated? Chris Burden responds, I watched the BBC nomination broadcast on my iPad alone in the studio. On hearing that Captain Phillips had received 6 nominations, a little arithmetic, and I started messaging my wife to say that I was very sure I had not received a nomination. I had assumed that Tom Hanks and Paul Greengrass were certainties to have been nominated. Before I could finish texting my wife, a colleague came into the studio and said simply, congratulations.
Oh, wow.
I insisted on seeing the nomination in black and white on his iPhone before I really believed him. The text to my wife was given a radical rewrite.
Wow.
Does that mean Tom Hanks did not get nominated for that?
Something.
All right.
I don't know. We'll have to look and see.
Anyway, that was kind of a fun topic.
I thought very much fun.
Oh, let me read one more. One more. For sound editing again.
Okay.
Brent Burge, doesn't say what movie, got a nomination for sound editing. And how did you find out you had been nominated? The answer handwritten in big, bold letters. My wife came screaming down the hallway at 4 a.m.
Yeah. God, but she was naked. Good for her.
Man, Robin, making me feel like I'm being left out of everything. All right. Let's move forward. And when we come back with Galen Unold.
Is it better than sex?
What are we going to do? We're going to talk about vending machine things that are now available.
New weird vending machines.
Yeah, kind of crazy stuff. All right.
Yeah.
All right. We'll take a break and be right back.
Like it or not, springtime is just around the corner, and so is spring cleaning and those winter projects you've been putting off. But don't worry, Sunbelt Rentals is here to make your job a little easier. Our knowledgeable staff will help you find the right equipment for any job, big or small. Did you know that Sunbelt Rentals carries heaters, air conditioners, generators, lighting, traffic control, and so much more? So whether you're building it up or knocking it down, we've got the equipment you need. Get it done, rent it now. And right now, for a limited time, you can have it for less. Just by mentioning this ad, if you rent it Friday afternoon, you can keep it the whole weekend and only pay for one day. But this is a limited time offer, so stop into Sunbelt Rentals today, Northwest 27th, just a quarter mile east of I-75. For more information, just give us a call, 352-369-9101. 352-369-9101. Sunbelt Rentals. Get it done, rent it now.
Here are today's headlines from the source, WOCA. Marion County Fire Rescue responded to a fire at SCI Asphalt at 7410 Northwest Gainesville Road in Reddick yesterday afternoon. A plant employee placed the emergency call at 1:14 p.m., stating that the system's hot oil lines were on fire. Marion County Fire Rescue crews were on the scene 10 minutes later and began attacking the flames with foam and water. 11 units responded and had the fire, which was caused by malfunctioning heating coils, out in less than half an hour. No injuries were reported. A West Palm Beach woman faces federal charges of identity theft and tax fraud after investigators say she stole personal information from more than 700 people. Tia LaShonda Miller, who is 39 years old, is accused of stealing the information and keeping it in a notebook that included names, dates of birth, and social security numbers, according to a news release from the United States Attorney for the Southern District of Florida. Investigators also say Miller might have used some of the names to get prescription drugs, according to federal court records. Miller and two others were arrested in October of 2012 for credit card fraud greater than $100 in Martin County. Officers were called to the Treasure Coast Mall for a report of shoplifting. What they found were notebooks filled with 726 names and social security numbers. 20 debit cards as well and an iPad were in her possession, according to federal records. Hospital emergency rooms cannot fix dental problems, but they are increasingly the medical destination for the state's underinsured, according to a new study. More than 139,000 Floridians with toothaches, oral sores, cavities, and related complaints sought out the emergency departments in 2012, which is a 6.4% increase over the previous year, according to the Florida Public Health Institute. The price? About $141 million. Dr. Roderick King, executive director of the institute, said that most patients seeking such treatment were either covered by taxpayer-supported Medicaid or were uninsured, meaning the hospital likely picked up the tab. Medicaid beneficiaries commonly complain that they can't find dentists willing to accept their insurance outside of nonprofit providers. Dentists have long complained that Medicaid payments in Florida are too low. Florida has allowed backyard gun ranges since 1987, but many cities banned them anyway. And that all changed in 2011 when Florida legislators created severe penalties for elected officials who enact or enforce their own local gun laws. They can be fined up to $5,000, removed from office without a hearing, and held liable for their own legal bills if anyone challenges the local gun laws. State Representative Matt Getz, a Republican from Fort Walton Beach, sponsored the House bill in 2011. State Senator Joe Negron, a Republican from Stewart, was the sponsor in the Senate. In late January, a gun owner named Doug Vorier set up a gun range in the backyard of his home on Big Pine Key in South Florida. Neighbors complained, but Monroe County officials said state law left them powerless to have it removed. On February 12th, Vorier sent a letter to Governor Rick Scott and Attorney General Pam Bondi, assuring them